Let us go and continue with our lesson, and today we'll go and learn about the long data type in Kotlin. So first of all, let me go and create a variable of long over here, and I'll say var, and I'll say my long one, and I'll just explicitly mention it as a long data type over here, and which is has equals value of a 0, and let me give a space over here, and also create another variable of my long 2, and I will not explicitly mention a value over here or a data type over here, and let me say just equals to and assign a value of 0. And now by default it is of integer data type, but if you want to convert it to a long data type, we can just pass a L over here, and that will be as a long data type over here. Now we have explicitly mentioned this as a long. So after value, we can put a L on uppercase that will be available for us to create a variable as a long data type. So now if you press or click over here and press Control Shift and B, it will take you to the primitive data type. Control Shift and B, it will take you to the primitive data type of long. So that means this is now a long data type. And if you remove L over here, and if you press again Control Shift and B, it will go to the int. So which is now this is an integer data type. So if you want to create a long data type, you can just give as a L over here. So that's another way we can explicitly mention of a long data type other than this one. So there is two ways that we can make use of. And let's go down, and I will just go over here, and I will just say as of a long which. And I will say that my long one is equals to value of, let's say, 10,000. And so another one is my long two. Okay. Oh, I made a mistake over here. Sorry for that. So it should be my long two is equals to minus 10,000. Which can hold both a positive and a negative number. And let's go and see about the range over here. And it says long is equals to 64-bit. That is a very huge. 64-bit is equals to how many byte? It should be of a 8 byte byte. So 64-bit and 8 bytes are double the size of the integer. If you see the integer size, and you can see the long size, which is a 64-bit and 8 byte. So which is a very huge number. So if you think that you need a very large number that you can to hold a value, then make use of a long. Don't go for long if you can, if you think that your value can be held within the range of a integer, or don't go for an integer if you think that your value can be held within a short, and don't go for a short if you think that your number is for can be held using a byte over here. So that's if you think that this is a 64-bit, it's a 4-byte, it's a huge memory consumption for your app. And let's go and see the range. So let's see the range is, let's say RANG range. It can hold range is equals to, we can give of a negative number from 2 to the power of 63 over here. And it can also go to up to positive number of 2 to the power of 63. So that is range, and it can hold both SIG and it assigned numbers, NUMBER assigned numbers, which is equals to negative and a positive number, NUMBER. Yeah, so the range, you can see it's a quite huge. If you want to calculate, you can go find for a exponent calculator or a 2 to the power calculator, and you can get the actual range of this long data type, which can hold a very huge number. So unless and until you require that to hold that big large number, don't go for a long. So we can also make use of another type of long data type over here, which if I create a local variable of a var, and I will say as my long 3, and I will assign a value of 1. Okay, if you see, just see over the value over here, and just click here and go to Control Shift and B from your keyboard. If you go to the int, and let me check again. So if we assign more value over here, so if we assign more value, and if you go over here and check that value type or data type, Control Shift and B again, it will still in the int, but let me assign some more. I think that's still in the range of the integer. Let me go again. It's go to the long over here. So it's when you are adding the value, and it's if the range is out of the integer, it will be automatically the range will be added for a long data type. So if you can see over here, previously it was of an integer. If you remove this one, and it will, if you go over here, and you can check that the data type is of an integer now, right? But if you add a value over here, some more data that is that cannot be held with the range of the integer data type, and this value can only hold by a long data type. So if you go over here and check, it will be okay, still in int, sorry for that. Let me add one more zero over here, and let me check. I think that should be fine. Let's go to the long over here. So that depend on how you create a variable. You can also make use of this as a data type of a long, because by default, if first it will be converted to the integer data type if you never explicitly mention over here, and after the value increase, that if the integer value cannot hold it, then it will be converted to the long by default. So that's it for the long, and then how we can make use in a Kotlin. So we will meet up in the next lecture, and we'll see about the floating point on a Kotlin.